Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, we're going to talk about the Face-Aware Liquify in Photoshop. Inside the Liquify plugin, there's a new Face-Aware feature that automatically identifies individual facial features and gives you the power to adjust those features. This is an improved and expanded version of the Face-Aware technology found in Photoshop Fix, a mobile application. Let me show you how that works. I'm going to go into the filter menu and I'm going to click on Liquify. And you already may be familiar with the Liquify feature, but this version includes a new feature. Notice this icon here, that is the face tool. And what happens is that Photoshop detects any faces found in your image. You can disable it by clicking on any other tool, and you can re-enable it again by clicking on this icon or pressing A on the keyboard. Notice that as I hover over the image, I get these displays over the face. So Photoshop knows that this is a face and we can make some adjustments. And before we move forward, let's take a look at the right-hand side of the panel. First of all, notice that it looks a little bit different than older versions, but we have this option here called Face-Aware Liquify, and we have some of the facial features here that we can adjust. We can adjust them by either clicking and dragging on the handles here. So notice how her eyes are getting bigger and smaller if I click and drag up. I can also adjust her jaw, her lips. This is actually the bottom lip or the upper lip. I can actually give her a smile or not. And I can make any type of adjustments just by clicking and dragging on these handles. Also, I want you to notice that if I hover over an area and you get that four-sided arrow, you can click and drag and move that facial feature, in this case, the eye. We can do the same thing with the nose. And we can do the same thing with the mouth. Now, if you want to make more refined adjustments, come into these sliders here on the right, and you can adjust each of these specific areas. So if you want to adjust the eyes, you can just click and drag this slider to the left or right and just make any adjustments that you need. I'm not going to click and drag on all the sliders just because they're very self-explanatory. So you can just come in and play around with them, but I just want you to see the power of this filter. Also, one thing I want to mention is that you can come in here and use any of the old Liquify tools. For example, I'm going to click on the warp tool and I'm going to increase the size of my brush by tapping on the right bracket key on my keyboard and just make some distortions to her face. Now she looks like an alien. Notice that even after making these adjustments, I can press A on the keyboard to go back into the Face-Aware Liquify tool, and I can continue making adjustments to her eyes, and the distortions from the warp tool did not disrupt the Face-Aware feature. So for now, I'm gonna press cancel, and I'm gonna open up another image. It's this selfie here, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna go into Filter, Liquify, and notice what happens now. Photoshop automatically detects the faces of everybody in this scene. I can click on select face and we have the numbers 1 through 5. So the way Photoshop aligns them is from left to right. So this is face 1, face 2, face 3, face 4, and face 5. So for example, if we want to select this girl here in the middle, that is face number 4. And we can adjust her forehead or make any other adjustments that we like. Now, obviously in these examples, I'm going a little extreme. I'm clicking and dragging these sliders to the far end just so that the adjustments are noticeable. But obviously when you're working on a portrait or a group shot like this, the adjustments that you make are gonna be very subtle. So keep that in mind, unless of course you're trying to create a caricature or something like that. I also wanna point out that the Face-Aware feature does not work with profile shots, and with some semi-profile shots, you may get some issues. Also, if the face is tilted beyond 30 degrees, you will need to rotate the photo so that you can apply this effect. So for example, this girl here in the center, if her head were tilted just a little bit more to the right, the facial features would not be recognized. Once you press OK, the changes are going to be made into your image. Obviously, we were working on a regular layer. We were working destructively. Luckily for us, this feature also works with smart objects. So I can convert this into a smart object, go into Filter, Liquify, and make any other adjustments that I like. This time I'm adjusting face number 1, which is this guy. So any adjustments that I make, I can press OK and they will be made non-destructively. Also, I want you to notice one thing that happened here. When I adjusted this person's face, the Liquify tool created some transparent pixels. So if this was an adjustment that I actually wanted to make, I would have to come back in here and either fill that in with Content Aware or maybe just crop it out. Another thing that you can do with the Face-Aware Liquify is apply that filter to video. So I have a video here that we're going to use, but before we get started, I'm going to open up the timeline panel and I'm going to click on Create Video Timeline. So we're going to place our video here. I'm going to go into File, Place Linked, and I have an MP4, a video file here. And this is just me talking and moving my head around so you can see how this effect is going to work. It's a very short video, it's roughly 5 seconds. And applying this filter to a video works just like applying it to images. So now that we have the Liquify Face video layer here, you'll see it here in the timeline. And I'm actually going to delete the original layer just so we only have one layer to worry about and it's a little less confusing. So with this layer selected, I'm going to go into Filter, Liquify. In Photoshop, immediately it's going to recognize the face in the video, and we can make adjustments just as we did with the images. So I'm just going to make a few quick adjustments, something like that, and press OK. I can then click on the play button, and it's going to be a little choppy just because the video is not rendered, but as you can see, the effect was applied. I'm going to click and drag on this to zoom in into the video layer, and I'm just going to scroll through the video, and you can see how those adjustments were applied. I can come in here into the layers panel and disable the effect. So this is what it looks without it. And I can just enable the effect again, and you'll see how the effect is applied even though I'm moving around and talking. If you want to render out the video, just click on the flyout menu here and select Render Video. You can name it, and then you can click on Select Folder to decide where to save it, and the default settings with H.264 should work, and then click on Render. Here's a before and after of the Face-Aware Liquify filter applied to the video. And that's pretty much it. Let me know what you think about this feature. Leave a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, then click the like button and share it with a friend. If you're new to the Photoshop training channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.